no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child of God.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Welcome to another session of the Voice of Mercy. Praise the Lord. We're about to start. Please let's get connected, because tonight we're going to be looking at something very important. And I'm very positive that God will touch somebody tonight in the name of Jesus. We're about to start. Please let's get connected. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Okay. God bless you. Please share this live broadcast. Share this live broadcast. God bless you. Invite someone. It's a day of mercy. Mercy will speak for you and your life will be transformed. That's our caption. And I'm very positive that mercy will speak for you tonight. In the name of Jesus. Good evening, everybody from this side of the world. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Thank you for joining us. It's a privilege to have you here tonight. Wow. God bless you. Let's begin to appreciate God for life. We're running to the end of April, and God has been faithful. Let's give God praise tonight for everything that He has done. Somebody give God praise. Father, we worship you. Jesus, we give you praise. If not for you, by our side, the enemy would have swallowed us up. We are not ingrate not to acknowledge that this is you. We are indeed very grateful for everything. Lord, we say thank you. Somebody give God praise. Jehovah, we worship you tonight. Jehovah, we appreciate you tonight. Invincible God. La da bo shata kalibra gadada. Invincible God. Invincible God, we give you praise tonight. We are excited, Lord, because of everything that you have done for us. We are alive today. Jesus. Jesus. Thank you, Father, for my life. Alo supayata ligra gadada do shali bragada basuziata. We are grateful, Father. Le kala do shata prala tuziata. Thank you, Ancient of Days, the Lion of the Tribe of Judah. Le koso toko logodobo shata pala dadada. We give you praise tonight. We give you praise tonight. Le ko shiana kaduzia. Thank you for my life. Thank you for the life of all the participants of the Voice of Mercy. Lord, we give you praise. Le kosia nakalado. Ele de bo shalagadoshia. Ika palo subayata kalagada da bayata. Thank you, the King of Kings. Thank you, Most High. Leko palizia talosia naka. We give you praise, O God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Most High. Let your name be highly exalted. Somebody ask God for mercy tonight. We ask for your mercy tonight. We ask for your mercy tonight. Let your mercy prevail over judgment. Let your mercy speak, O God. Likrago shana kusiata. Lord, your mercy. Lord, show us mercy, Lord. Show us mercy. Show us mercy, O God. Show us your mercy, O God. Lord, your mercy. Your mercy, Holy Spirit, take your place tonight. Holy Spirit of God, take your place tonight. Take your place tonight. May our lives be changed. Take your place tonight. Take your place, Holy Spirit of God. Send a word our way. A word that will change our story forever. Send a word our way. A word that will break every chains of the devil. Send a word our way. A word of God that will settle us forever. Every yoke of sin, let your word break them off our lives. Every shackles of the devil, as your word comes forth, let it be destroyed forever. Let it be destroyed forever. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Amen. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Tonight, we're going to be looking at a very sensitive topic, living right. Last week, we looked at, can God trust you? Can God trust you? And I believe God so strong that so many lives are touched from that message. Today, we are going to be looking at living right. And our text will be taken from James chapter 4, verse 17. James chapter 4, verse 17. Hey, ladado shataka lagadada bayadagadosha. We bless you, Jesus. 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 Before we proceed to read our James chapter 4, verse 17, please invite someone to be a partaker of this blessing tonight. Invite someone to be a partaker of this blessing tonight. As you do so, God bless you. As you do so, God bless you. As you do so, God bless you. In the name of Jesus. James chapter 4, verse 17. Therefore, to him that knoweth to do good, and doeth it not, to him it is a sin. To him that knoweth to do good, and doeth it not, to him it is a sin. Praise the Lord. Amen. To him that knoweth to do good, and doeth it not, to him it is a sin. As adults, as children of God, we know our left from our right, just as we know the good from the bad. It is important that as children of God that we live right. It is important as children of God that we do the things that God requires us to do. It is important as children of God that we let go of the things that God doesn't want us to do. Praise the Lord. Living right as children of God is very important in our lives. Living right as children of God is very important in our lives. Now hear me. It is easy to live right when you have the fear of God inside of you. It is easy to live right when you have the fear of God inside of you. Living right is doing the things that are good in the sight of God. Living right is doing the things that are good in the sight of God. Living right is doing the things that are required of you as a child of God. God has placed his commandments for us to follow. Living right is obeying every single word that God has spoken. Living right is doing the things that God requires of you as a child of God. There are so many things that God wants us to let go of. We're going to be looking at them speedily from James chapter 4, verses 10. The Bible says, humble yourself in the sight of the Lord, and he shall lift you up.
God wants you to first humble yourself. There are so many people that are so arrogant. There are so many people that are proud. The Bible says God resists the proud and he gives grace to the humble. God resists the proud and he gives grace to the humble. Live it right. For you to live right, you must be humble. One of the things for you to do as a child of God, you must humble yourself in the sight of God. And he shall lift you up. He resists the proud, but he gives grace to the humble. As children of God, it is very important that you are humble. Because God will give you grace. God will give you grace. God will shower you with his favor. As you live right, as you humble yourself before the throne of grace, he will lift you up. Living right. God wants us to live right. God wants us to live right. God wants us to live right as children of God. God wants us to live right. See what James chapter 4 verses 11 is saying. He says, speak not evil one of another. How can we live right? Be humble. Number two, speak not evil one of another. Brethren, he that speaketh evil of his brother and judgeth his brother, speaketh evil of the law. Speak not evil of your brother. There are so many people, they come to your face and pretend as if they love you. Or they go to your back and they say all sort of things against you. As a child of God, it is very important that you do not use your mouth to spoil people's life. It is very important that you do not speak evil against the handmaid of the Lord. It is very important that you do not say things that will tarnish people's image. Praise the Lord. James chapter 3 verses 16 says, for where envy and strife is, there is confusion and every evil work. As children of God, it is time to live right. Let go of envy. Let go of strife. Where there is envy and strife, there is confusion. When A is envying B and B is envying C, everybody's doing one thing or the other to hurt one another. And that is not the quality of the child of God. You need to live right as a child of God. When we were looking at, can God trust you? The Bible says, he that is faithful, he that is faithful, he that is faithful in small will be faithful in mighty. God wants us to live right as his children. For where envy and strife is, there is confusion and every evil work. Now, guess what? When you are in the midst of people that envy and there is strong strife, you will begin to see people that are plotting to kill one another. That is not supposed to be found amongst children of God. God wants us to live right. Jesus is coming soon. He wants us to live right. For where envy and strife is, there is confusion and there is evil everywhere. God wants us to stay away from anything that will cause strife amongst ourselves. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Look at what Ephesians chapter 4 verses 22 is saying. That ye put off concerning the former conversation, the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust. You have given your life to Christ. The Bible says old things are passed away. Behold, all things are new. That you put off the former conversation, those things that you were doing before, arrogance, envy, pride, put them off. Put them off. Put them off. And wear the garment of Jesus, the new man, which he has placed upon your life. Praise the Lord. Therefore, that ye put up the old conversation, which is the old man, which is corrupt. The old man is corrupt. The life of sin is corruption. The life of sin is death. The life of sin is full of confusion. A life without Jesus is a life of crisis. A life without Jesus is a life of crisis. God wants us to live right. God wants us to live right because he has chosen you to be his handmaid. He wants us to live right. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Ephesians chapter 4, verses 25. Therefore, putting away lying, speak every man truth with his neighbor, for we are members of one of another. Put away lying tongues. Put away lying tongues. People can lie against each other. People can lie at the slightest opportunity they have. They can lie to even put people in problems. That is not how to live right. Put away lying. As a child of God, this attribute should not be found in our lives. As children of God, these attributes should not be found in our lives. Wherefore, putting away lying, God wants us to always speak the truth, no matter the situation that we find ourselves. Who are we afraid of? Why do people tell lies? Who are you afraid of? The man that can kill your body but cannot kill your spirit. Who are you afraid of? Wherefore, putting away lying, speak every man truth with his neighbor, for we are members one of another. We are one in God's kingdom. We are the children of God. We have one Father, which is God. He wants us to live right. Put away every old man, every appearance of sin, every appearance of lust. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Put away every appearance of sin. Ephesians 4:28. Let him that stole steal no more. Mercy is speaking for you tonight. Whatever that you have been doing before, tonight, mercy will speak for you. Amen. Let him that stole steal no more. There is something about God. No matter your past, no matter where you are coming from, no matter the sin you have committed, no matter what you have done, a contrite heart, it will not despair. Any heart that comes back to God, a repentant heart that says, Father, I am here, please forgive me, God will not send you out of his presence. Let him that stole steal no more. Let him that stole steal no more. But rather let him labor, working with his hand the things which is good, that he may have to give to him that needeth. Let him that stole steal no more. It is better to even do small jobs than for you to steal. God don't want you to steal. God wants you to live right. God wants you to flee from every appearance of sin. God wants you to flee from every appearance of evil. He said, let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth. Let nothing that is corrupt come out from your mouth. Sometimes we might be joking and say some things that we're not supposed to say in the name of joke. But gradually, these words are becoming part of our lives. We say things that we're not supposed to say. Gradually, these words are becoming part of our lives. Let no evil communication come out from your mouth. But that which is good to the use of edifying, that it may minister grace unto the hearer. What is that word that you say to your parents? What is that word that you say to your siblings, to your children? Does it minister grace to their lives? Does it minister grace to their lives? Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth. Whatever that comes out from your mouth, let it be edifying and let it minister grace to the hearer. Now hear what 31 says. Let all bitterness, let all wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you, even with malice. It will shock you to know that there are people in the house of God that they don't talk to one another. It will shock you to know there are people in the house of God that don't forgive. There are people in the house of God that still go to church with bitterness. He said, that usher offended me that day. This person did this thing to me that day. Hear me. Let all bitterness, whatever that is paining you in your heart, even if somebody has offended you. Bible says, be angry, but sin not. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. Let all bitterness be taken out of your life. Let wrath and anger and clamor and evil speaking be put away from you. Amen. With all malice, let it be taken out of your life. You need to live right. Some people can go to church and clean the house of God and sow seed and give tithes. But if God gives you the opportunity to look at their heart, their heart is filled with wickedness. Their heart is filled with envy. Their heart is filled with unforgiveness. If God can say, I will not forgive you, who can stand? If God can say, I will not forgive you, who can stand? It is time for us to let go of unforgiveness and forgive one another. Because we are all children of God. Because we are children of the Most High God. God is our Father. It says, and be a kind one to another. Tender-heartedness. Forgiving one another, even as God, for Christ's sake, has forgiven you. So people will say, I will never forgive this person. If I forgive this person, let this thing happen to me. If I forgive this person, let this thing happen to me. And we call ourselves children of God. and be ye kind to one another. Your attitude, does it glorify God? Even in the compound that you stay, are you not the most troublesome person there? But when it is time to go to church, you are the first person to be in church. But our heart is filled with wickedness. Our heart is filled with unforgiveness. The Bible speaking, forgiving one another, no matter the gravity of the offense that somebody has done against you. Somebody said, if you don't forgive, that the person that you are holding grudge against is living a rent-free life in your mind. If you don't forgive, somebody is actually living rent-free in your heart. And guess what? You that don't want to forgive, it is you that will not even have peace. It is you that will not even have peace. God wants you to have peace, and that is why he's saying that we should forgive one another and be ye kind to one another. Be ye kind to one another. Be ye kind to one another. The world is cold enough. Be kind. The world is cold enough. Be wise. The world is cold enough. Be nice. The world is cold enough. People are dying of depression. People are dying of one thing or the other. Be kind to people. Just as God is kind to you. Just as God is kind to you. Be kind to people. Be ye kind to one another. Tender-heartedness. Forgiving one another. Even as God, for Christ's sake, has forgiven you. Praise the Lord. Living right. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Somebody said, there are so many people that don't read the Bible these days, that they see you as a believer. They see you, this one is going to church, or this one is a Christian. Let us even see how this person lives. And through you, they are reading their Bibles already. And they say, if this sister can do this, that means God truly exists. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. We're talking about can God trust you last week, and we established a fact that the reason why so many people are not blessed is because God has seen their hearts, and God knows that this one, if I give this one this thing, this one will cause havoc everywhere. If I give this person this thing, anger will take the better part of this person. Pride and arrogance will set in. Let your light shine. Put away that attitude that is making people to look at you and they wonder the kind of God that you serve. It is time to live right, because God wants us to be an example to others. God wants us to be an example to others. God wants us, our lights, to shine bright. And people see us and they will say, wow, this person is truly a child of God. Take away anger from your life. Take away malice from your life. Take away unforgiveness from your life. Take away pride out of your life. Take away evil speaking out of your life. And do the things that God wants you to do. Now see what Ecclesiastes chapter 12 verses 13 is saying. He said, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. What does God want you to do as a child of God? Fear God and keep his commandments. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. That is to say, there are set rules that have been put in place before. Now, the conclusion of all the rules and regulations that have been put in place for you as a child of God. Fear God and keep his commandments. For this is the whole duty of man. As a child of God, it is your duty to fear God. As a child of God, it is your duty to fear God. It is your duty to keep his commandments. Fear God and keep his commandments. For this is the whole duty of a man. If you know that somebody has offended you and you are failing to forgive, please pick up your phone and send a message to that person. I say, my brother, my sister, I have forgiven you. Please forgive me also. I have forgiven you. Please forgive me also. Let go of that bitterness in your heart. Let go of that anger and unforgiveness. God wants to visit you, but there are so many powers that are blocking the entrance. The spirit of unforgiveness can stop your blessing from reaching you. Bitterness and strife, hear me. The Holy Spirit cannot dwell in a sorrowful environment. In an environment where there is anger, where there is bitterness, where there is strife, the Holy Spirit cannot dwell there. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandments. But this is the whole duty of a man. This is your duty as a child of God. This is your duty as a child of God. Hear me right now. Fear God and keep his commandment. These days we have so many churchgoers, but so many people are just going to mark register in church. They don't understand what it takes to fear God. If you fear God, you will not bear false witness against your neighbor. If you fear God, you will not tell lies. If you fear God, you will not fornicate. If you fear God, you will not do the things that God don't want you to do. Fear God and keep his commandment, for this is the whole duty of a man. Praise the Lord. I know some people will no longer be my friend, but the truth must be spoken. The truth must be said. It is time for us to brace up. It is time for us to return back to God. So many people are far, far, far away from God. God wants you home. And that is why God is telling you to live upright. Come back to God. He needs you. See what verse 14 is saying. He said, for God shall bring every work into judgment. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandment, for this is the whole duty of a man. For God shall bring every work into judgment. That is to say, the things that you do in secret, he is seeing it. He will bring it to judgment. The things that you do in open, he is still seeing it. He will bring it to judgment. Even if you are doing good in secret, God will bring it to judgment. And the day God will smile on you, that day the whole world will know that you serve a living God. It is time to live right. He that knoweth the right thing to do and is not doing it, to him it is a sin. To him it is a sin. Because God has laid down his rules for us to follow, his commandments that we should follow. So God shall bring every work into judgment with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. God will bring it into judgment. The Bible says in Revelation, it says, he that is holy, let him be holy. He that is righteous, let him be righteous. He that is filthy, let him be filthy. He said, behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give to every man according to his work. Ha, lado, shata, kata. And my reward is with me to give to every man according to his work. He that is holy, let him be holy. He that is righteous, let him still be righteous. He that is filthy, keep on being filthy. He said, for I come quickly. I come quickly. My reward is with me to give to every man according to his works. And that is what he's still saying in Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 14. For God shall bring every work into judgment with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. Ask yourself this question. What am I doing that is against the commandments of God? What am I doing that is against the commandments of God? He said, fear me and keep my commandments, for this is your duty as a child of God. What is that thing that I am doing that God is frowning at? Proverbs chapter 6 from verse 16. Didn't you see what Jesus said there? There are six things that the Lord hates. Behold, seven are abomination unto him. It's time to live right. There are six things that the Lord hates. Behold, seven are abomination unto him. Number one, a proud look. You that look down on your neighbor today, don't forget that God is watching, and tomorrow, that person can sleep a poor man and wake up a rich man tomorrow. A lying tongue. Hands that shed innocent blood. The feet that hurry up to do evil. False witnesses. People that bear false witnesses against their neighbor. It is time to live right. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandment, for this is the whole duty of a man. If somebody has offended you, pick up your phone tonight and send a message to that person. Tell the person, I forgive you from my heart. Let it go. Let it go. Because God wants to touch you. God wants to touch you. God wants to touch you. God is calling you now. God is calling you now. Now hear me. If God will give so many people the opportunity to come back to this earth again, when they come back, they will come and tell you that hellfire is real. So many people are seeking for the opportunity just to come back to this life again. So many destinies, so many talents are buried in the grave. You have the opportunity to accept Jesus once again into your life. You have given your life to Christ, and maybe some people, they are fallen by the wayside. It is time to rededicate your life to God. Father, anything that I am doing that will not bring glory to your name, tonight I plead for your mercy. I plead for your mercy. I plead for your mercy. Somebody ask God for mercy. Let God show you mercy tonight. Jesus is coming soon. Jesus is coming soon. You have the opportunity to hear this word tonight. Let go of that bitterness. Let go of that strife. Let go of that anger. Hear me. There are some blessings that will come to you when you are righteous. There are some blessings that will come to you without even praying. Just living right. Just living right. Just living right. The day I came across that scripture in Revelation, it said, he that is filthy, let him be filthy. He that is righteous, let him be righteous. He that is holy, let him be holy. He said, behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give to every man according to his work. Ah, you have the opportunity now to turn back to Jesus. Jesus is calling you. Jesus wants you back. Jesus wants you back. So many people have gone astray. Many people are fighting with evil spirits of bitterness, with evil spirit of strife, with evil spirit of jealousy, hatred. Some people hate their neighbor. Some people hate their siblings. It is time to come back home. It is time to come back home. Hear me. It is time to come back home. Jesus speaking to you tonight. He said, I come quickly. I come quickly. My reward is with me to give to every man according to your work. Jesus is calling you. Jesus wants you back. Jesus wants you back. Jesus wants you back. The potter wants to put you back together again. I don't care the years that you have been in sin. I don't care what you have been doing all these years. Just run back to God. He will forgive your sins. He will have mercy upon you. He will heal your land. If my people that are calling my name can humble themselves and stay away from sin and turn away from their wicked ways. He said, I will hear them. I will heal their land. Somebody has God for mercy tonight. Say, Father, show me mercy. Show me mercy. Show me mercy, oh God. I have done things that I am not proud of. I have done things that I am not proud of. Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. That is to say, there is a matter already on ground. God wants you to fear him. God wants you to keep his commandments. He said, this is your duty as a child of God. It is time to come back home. 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 So many people don't want to hear this message right now. But I tell you the truth. If you can just turn back and come back to God, everything that your heart everly desires, God will grant it unto you. Just ask God for mercy tonight. Say, Father, have mercy upon me. I plead for your mercy, Jesus. Lord, please show me mercy tonight. Show me mercy tonight. Show me mercy, oh God. Lord, I ask for your mercy. I have gone astray, Lord. I have gone so very far from you. I ask for your mercy. I ask for your mercy. I ask for your mercy. I have not been doing your work rightly. I have not been working rightly with you, Lord. Somebody's heart is filled with bitterness. God is speaking to you tonight. Let it go. God is speaking to you tonight. Let it go. I don't care what the person has done to you. I don't care what has transpired between you and that person. God wants you to let it go because he wants to heal you, because he wants to touch you. If your heart is filled with bitterness, let go of that bitterness. Let go of that bitterness. God wants to touch you tonight. God wants to heal you tonight. Just let it go of unforgiveness, of anger and strife. Lord, show me mercy tonight. I let it go tonight. I give it all up for you. I drop it at your feet. I know people might have done some things to you that has hurt you that bad, but God wants you to live right. God wants you to live right. Let it go tonight. Let go of that sin that is dragging you back. Let go of that sin. Let go of that thing that you are doing that is not bringing glory to God. Let it go tonight. Of that thing that you are addicted to, every addiction, let it go tonight. Say, Holy Spirit of God, break me tonight. Help me to live right. 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 Help me to do the things that you want me to do. Spirit of God, I ask for your mercy. I ask for your mercy. Have mercy upon Catherine. The things I'm supposed to do, I left them undone. The things I'm not supposed to do, that I have done. Lord, have mercy upon me. Lord, have mercy upon me. Have mercy upon me, O God. Balo shata palado siata. Your mercy, O God. Your mercy, O God. God is calling you back home. It is time to come back home. It is time to come back home. God wants you back home. He wants you back. He wants you back. You have gone astray for too long. Have you not wondered enough? Life without Christ is full of crises. I know you have a past, and you are scared that God might not be able to forgive you. Now hear me. As many that are willing to come back to him, he doesn't care about your past. He wants you now. He wants you back home. He wants you back home. Ask God to help you tonight. Say, God, help me to do the things that are right. Help me, oh God. I am not perfect, Father. I just need you to help me. Somebody ask God to help you. Lord, help me to live right. Father, help me to live right. Jesus, help me to live right. Lord, help me to live right. Father, help me to do the right things in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Most High. Thank you, Most High. Lord, I give you praise. I pray tonight that heart that is filled with bitterness, that heart that is filled with bitterness, I pray that the Holy Spirit of God will touch you. I pray that the Holy Spirit of God will help you to let it go. To let it go, to forgive, no matter the sin that the person might have committed, no matter what the person might have done to you that is making your heart to bleed. Tonight, please let it go. God wants you back home. God wants you back home. These things are slowing you down. These things are drawing you back. They are luggages that you need to drop. These are luggages, the spirit of bitterness, the spirit of unforgiveness, strife. There are luggages that you need to drop. Ask God to help you to drop them. Lord, help us tonight. Spirit of the living God, give us the grace to live right. In the name of Jesus. Say, God, resist the proud and gives grace to the humble. Say, Father, help me to stay humble. Help me to stay humble. Help me to stay humble. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let your fire begin to burn in my life. Let your fire burn in my life. Let your fire burn in my life. Let your fire burn in my life. Burn out everything that is not of God. Every spirit that is not of God in my life that is slowing me down. Lord, please have mercy and let that spirit get out of my life tonight. Now we break the chain of unforgiveness. We break the chain of addiction. We break the chain of sin. We break the chain of bitterness, envy, strife, hatred. We break the chains of fornication. We break the chains of sin in our lives. In the name of Jesus. And we ask, Holy Spirit of God, that you take charge of our life. We ask that you have mercy upon your children. We ask that you have mercy upon us. Touch us again. Touch us again. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Most High God. Thank you, the lily of the valley. Thank you, the bright and the morning star. Somebody declare, I am no longer a slave to sin. I am no longer a slave to sin. Somebody declare, I am no longer a slave to sin. I am a child of God. I am no longer a slave to sin. I am a child of God. I am no longer a slave to sin. I am a child of God. I declare today, I am no longer a slave to sin. I am your child, oh God. Thank you, the King of Kings. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray. Praise the Lord. Somebody declare that I am a child of God. Let the devil know that you are no longer a slave to sin. You are no longer a slave to sin.
You are a child of God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Please endeavor to pray like never before. The Bible says men ought to pray and all and not offend. The Bible says study to show thyself approved unto God. It is time for us to come back to God. It is time for us to do the things that are right. It is time for us to trust God again. Study to show thyself approved unto God. Let the word of God be your lifestyle. Let the word of God be your lifestyle. And as you do so, heaven will help you. God will sustain you in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you so much for joining us. Please, if you want to give your life to Christ, or you want to rededicate your life back to God, somebody pray this prayer with me. Say, Lord Jesus, I turn back to you today. I ask that you forgive me. I ask that you cleanse me. I ask that you help me. I want to love you better. I want to know you deeper all the days of my life. I decree and declare, no going back. I am not a slave to sin. I am not a slave to the devil. I am a child of God. I am born again. I rededicate my life back to you, Lord. I ask that you help me. I ask that you help me. Thank you, Father, for accepting me. For in Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If you said that prayer, God bless you. If you said that prayer, God bless you. Please endeavor to study the word of God. Endeavor to study the word of God. Endeavor to always study the word of the Lord. Endeavor to pray. If you know that you don't have that strength to pray, connect with somebody that prays and let that person be your prayer partner. It is time to let it go. Don't forsake the gathering of the children of God. As you do so, God will bless you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you so much for joining us. Thank you very much for joining us. The Voice of Mercy holds every Wednesday by 7 p.m. Tomorrow is night of settlement. By 11:30 p.m. Please put it at the back of your mind that we are praying tomorrow night. Night of settlement, be there. We are going to pray like never before. And I believe God so strong that you will attend to all our needs in Jesus' name. On Saturday is prophetic hour. Wow, I saw so many mind-blowing testimonies from last week's Saturday's prophetic hour. Don't miss Saturday's prophetic hour by 8 p.m. Don't be told, be there, because God will touch you in the name of Jesus. God will touch you. Please share this live broadcast so that somebody's life will be touched. Thank you so much once again for joining us. Thank you for joining us. Thank you so much for joining us. God bless you. Don't forget what I said. If anybody has offended you, pick up your phone and send a message to that person. I forgive you. Please forgive me. Let go of bitterness. Let brotherly love continue. As you do so, God bless you. Thank you for joining us. My name is Minister Kathy. God bless you.
You unravel me with a melody. You surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies, till all my fears have come. Yeah.